What we're going to start with is an overview of the working groups and the territory of the technical activities by our cameraman, Hugh. And then in this first session, then we will go into the best practices board by our co-chair, Koizumi-san, and Shweta, trying to be anonymous back here, will give us an overview of FRTA 1.5.
Hey, morning everybody. My name's Hugh Wallis. I'll be very, very brief because this is a very short session with a lot of information. So I'm just going to give you a very quick overview of what the Standards Board working groups have been doing since the Beijing conference. This slide summarizes it. I'll go through each one of these sections individually shortly. So in the versioning working group, there have been numerous updates that have been published. The rendering working group, inline XBRL, is in production. There have been some updates published. There's a transformation registry version 2 that's been published. And the rendering link base requirements are proceeding, and they're somewhat slowly, but there's some interesting developments that we'll be hearing about later on in this session, later on today. Base specification group have published a proposed edited recommendation, moving the focus from precision to decimals, and a few adjunct modules have also been advanced by that group. The formula working group, the extension modules have been advanced to a proposed recommendation status, almost all of them. There's one that still has more work to be done on. We've also introduced two new registries, the data types registry and the units registry, and I'll talk about those in a moment as well. And last but by absolutely no means least, because we've got a whole hour on this stuff later, is the strategic initiatives, particularly the abstract modeling and the comparability, which Ray Lam will be talking about in more detail later. So for versioning, the primer overview and use cases working group notes, there have been two updates since Beijing as public working drafts, and the requirements continue to be updated based upon implementation feedback for the whole versioning suite of specs. Versioning for dimensions is pretty complicated stuff. It's really broken down into two specs, which have the very intuitive names of instance aspects and relationship sets. We've published two cycles of each of those ones, and relationship sets has now just been promoted to candidate recommendation. The instance aspects spec is still needs some more work to be done on it. That's the more complicated one. And the basic specs from versioning base, concept basic, and concept extended are in second candidate recommendation status now. Those specifications are very close to stable, and we anticipate those moving through to recommendation very, very rapidly now. We've had plenty of feedback from implementation, and as I said, things are looking pretty stable as a result of that. For rendering, the inline XBRL spec is now in production use at Her Majesty's Revenue and Customs in the United Kingdom and elsewhere. A couple of errata corrections to the transformation registry have been published, and there's now a new transformation registry in public working draft status. This has been delivered as a result of the desire to incorporate a lot of information related to Asian languages in particular, and date formats and so on and so forth. So a lot of more sophisticated transformations are built into the transformation registry, and some of those transformation functions have been made more generic as a result of that. So some sort of refactoring has gone on there. The work on the rendering link-based requirements has proceeded, and actually we made some huge progress yesterday at the rendering working group meeting. Rendering link-based is going to be a long, complicated process, taking it in small bitten-off chunks, and the table link-based is where some of the initial wins are going to happen, and that's well underway now. The base specification working group, there's been extensive work that they've done to change the focus from a computer science-y type of focus to a more business-orientated focus in terms of how you specify the accuracy of the information that's in an instance. We used the primary focus, the way the spec was originally written, was to focus on what's known as precision, which is a very computer science-y way of looking at things, you know, talking much about rounding as numbers are stored in a computer processor. Whereas really what we're finding is that there's much more understanding and much more use of what we call decimals, which is essentially the way that that most end users think about the accuracy of a number that's being presented, being reported. And we have created some changes to the base specification that have gone out for public review, just been published out for public review. These will require some fairly extensive public consultation because it is a change to the base specification. We do need feedback from software vendors and users on that, because it will require some software changes if it is eventually decided to edit the recommendation to support that change of approach. As part of that process, there's been a review using the extensive database of filings to the SEC, and that's been pretty encouraging in terms of what sort of impact there's going to be. There will be some impact, but it's not going to sort of blow everything out of the water. So that's the feedback so far on that. The base specification working group has also done some work on some of the adjunct sort of supporting specifications, some of the smaller ones like generic references, generic preferred labels. And those are largely to support other working groups' needs. These are specs that are in use by the work that's being done by a number of other working groups, and so they've been looked after by the base specification group. The formula working group, there's a bunch of additional modules. They've progressed things like tuple output, a function updates to the functions registry. To some extent, progress has been hampered by this sort of chicken and egg situation, which comes first, the chicken or the egg. Some users are not prepared to implement formula until the specification is at recommendation. But you can't proceed to recommendation until you get feedback on implementation. So it's like a catch-22 thing going on there. So very few potential implementers are prepared to participate in this working group development and review process. So we would encourage anybody with an interest in formula to join up with the formula working group and get actively involved in providing that review to the work that's being done there. We also recognize that formula is exceedingly complicated and very tricky. It's a very sophisticated tool, and so we feel the need that not only should we be producing the basic specification, but a bunch of additional explanatory material. And we have been reaching out to try to find people that would volunteer to help produce some of this material. That's already started to bring forth fruit here this week, and if anybody else has an interest in getting involved, really understanding formula and helping to produce more explanatory material on formula, we'd very, very much like to hear from you. And your point person is Herm here, over in the corner, or me, that would be very, very welcome. There is an open source implementation available. This is not an official XBRL International product, but it is an open source implementation of the specification that users can go and look at to get ideas as to how they might go about implementing this specification. Registries. We've had two new registries have been created. There's the data types registry, which we were finding that there was a large number of data types were being used in actual filings, but everyone was making up their own version of them. So we sort of tried to assemble all those together and put them into one registry so that people can actually reference this registry of data types, so that you don't have everybody making up the same thing again and again and again. That will enhance comparability of XBRL artifacts, XBRL instances, if everyone's using, and XBRL taxonomies, if everyone's using the same data type when they mean the same thing. So there's a registry there, that's at xbrl.org/dtr, data type registry, if you care to go and look for it. And associated with that is just published the first public working draft of a units registry. Again, as you probably know, in an instance document, you define the units that are associated with a particular number. But again, that's all over the shop. You know, people have kilograms as K or KG, uppercase K, lowercase G, etc., etc. So the idea here is to create a consistent set of unit identifiers that are in common use, and also to tie that into the data types registry so that we can say that these units should normally be used in association with these particular data types. So the other little rather neat feature of the units registry is that where you have different units of the same dimension, talking in the mathematical sense here, so for example a length dimension could be measured in feet, it could be measured in inches, it could be measured in meters. We've also included some MathML definitions in the registry to define the relationships between some of these different units. And the strategic initiatives, Ray Lam will be talking very soon on that, so I won't really go into that much further. The two strategic initiatives from the suite of six initiatives that the Standards Board published recently that are now underway are the creation of an abstract model and the data comparability initiative. I'll say no more on that. I'll leave that to Ray because it's a whole hour after we've finished. Now I need to hand over to Koizumi-san.
Good morning, everyone. Thanks for attending the session. My name is Koizumi of I am a chair of the Best Practice Board. Today, our session is only 30 minutes, and Hugh takes 15 minutes already. So I, keep my presentation shorter. I provide you the update from the Best Practice Board, introducing the overview of our entire activity. So, first of all, we are in a Best Practice Board is a group to collect the market practices and disseminate the practices to the market all over the world. And at the same time, we are the body to develop the best practices for XBRL adoption. And this year, we have three major goals. The one is creating the value proposition or white papers and practices to the market. And second goal is generating the best practices document, like for the financial reporting taxonomy architecture 1.5. And third one is we are renewing the taxonomy recognition process and create a template for expanding the taxonomy. So here is a position of these three initiatives. For every project manager, they need to make a decision, to adopt XBRL or adopt other technologies. So before decision making, they need to know, much information, more information about, detailed information about the XBRL. So this is a white paper or project listening database part. And after the project manager makes the decision. The guidance document, like FRTA or checklist for the project managers, are really good help for them. And later phase, after the taxonomy is developed, some project managers need a third-party certificate for the evaluation for their taxonomy. So the taxonomy recognition process really fit for the phase. There is a list of the activity this year, FRTA 1.5. That's a good guidance document for taxonomy development. And current status of the FRTA development is it's a public working draft and it's distributed to the public. Okay. We're gonna upload the latest FRTA 1.5 public working draft in this week. And we are now creating the some white papers, the consuming XBRL data, XBRL internal reporting, XBRL in integrated reporting, XBRL in banking, value proposition, generic value proposition document, and a taxonomy quality criteria document. That's most of the document plan to be finished in by the end of September. And also, we are renewing the taxonomy recognition process done by taxonomy recognition task force. And that's a we are now creating the the detailed project plan for the that project. And lastly, we're doing the renewing the project listing database, which contains the every project overview data from all over the world. And so far, we have 180 project in the database, and we're containing renewing that continue to renewing the database, and 13 members are in the project listing database task force, and they set the defining the action item this year. So Shweta will introduce the FRTA 1.5 next to me. But before passing to Shweta, I just want to introduce outcome in last year. All outcomes from the BPB is on the XII website. Last year we developed two white papers: financial supervision reporting and XBRL, and XBRL or customized XML. That's really good for IT project manager and the business side people. And also, the taxonomy, mainly taxonomy architecture working group, Shweta's group, developed some requests for comment. This is a technical discussion paper like that. And TRTF acknowledged the taxonomy all over the world. I think how many taxonomies did we acknowledge last year?
I don't have an immediate count, but it's
18 or 16, something like that.
Yeah.
Okay, so number of taxonomies acknowledged or approved by Taxonomy Recognition Task Force. If you are the project manager of the taxonomy and you need a third party evaluation, so let's ask Hugh and me. Okay. That's all outcome the last year, and I will pass the Shweta.
Good morning, everyone. So I'll briefly take you through the FRTA 1.5 that we are going to release as a public working draft soon. That is the update to FRTA 1.0, and you will find differences from FRTA 1.0 into FRTA 1.5, which I would explain immediately after that. And we've had brief discussions on what are the next steps after we've released FRTA 1.5. So a brief overview of that and the challenges we are facing and some of the answers that we think would be to overcome these challenges. So FRTA 1.5 was like an intermediate step or a short-term solution to remove all the obsolete rules from FRTA 1.0. Because all the taxonomies that were being acknowledged or approved did violate FRTA rules, and for perfectly valid reasons, because some of the rules had really become obsolete and were not in conformance to the practices in the current era. And they were requiring some modification in the existing rules, because they especially with dimension specification coming across, some rules were contradicting. And if the short term solution, if we do have a set of new rules, we could add them on to the FRTA 1.5. So it will be soon be uploaded on the website, and we would request you to go through that and comment so that we make sure that it caters to the immediate needs. So just to give some statistics, we had 19 rules that have been removed from FRTA, 11 rules that have been modified in terms of the text. And there's one rule only that has been added. And we've deleted the extension taxonomy section for the time being, because we're focusing on the base taxonomies. Like we say, it would also include IFRS extensions, but not extension taxonomies. And so some reasons why we did these changes was we removed all May rules because May rules really don't mean anything. They're just, you may have this, so we just removed them. Then there were some rules, example, you had a rule that all the arc roles within an extended link should be the same. That was not conforming to the dimension specification, so such kind of rules were deleted. Then there were some rules like a 12-character prefix rule, which almost every taxonomy was violating, and nobody knew why did we have a 12-character prefix rule. Then there were rules that have already been imposed by the XBRL 2.1 specification, for example, the period type constraint, which says every item must have a period type. So that's already there in the XBRL 2.1 specification. And there were some rules we got to make them more precise. We changed the text to remove any ambiguity which people have experienced over the past. So there were people who came up and said, you know, this rule is not clear, we don't understand, or there is some ambiguity in this rule. If you look at the FRTA 1.5 that will be released, in the end there is an appendix that will explain all the changes to the rules and why were they done. So if we look at the next steps, we've again divided the next steps into short-term and long-term because there is definitely a need to, every taxonomy that is being implemented across jurisdiction has its own structure and architecture, and there is also because each jurisdiction seems to have their own need and it depends on the scope of the taxonomy and so on. But yet there is always, there can always be a consolidated set of rules that apply to taxonomies across in general, and the short-term perspective is to identify these rules and request all the taxonomy owners to share these rules and practices that each of their taxonomies is based on, consolidate them to find one consolidated set of rules that can apply across. So that is so the next time someone is going ahead and building a taxonomy, they will have a consolidated set of rules to go across and know what each jurisdiction has done. So this, we hope, will slowly limit it down to the number of options we have, and we will not have software applications being built for different taxonomies. The long term is to create a logical model which will be aligned with the XSB's abstract model. So logical model to start with for financial reporting, and then identify various other reporting profiles which are being implemented across jurisdiction, and we continue with logical modeling of those profiles. So we've not really set goals for these two right as of now because we're focusing on financial reporting, which is by large the most number of implementations that are being happening across XBRL. But we do hope to have the various reporting profiles, which we will need to closely work with XSB also on that. So coming to challenges, we've identified two challenges that are really hindering our progress. One is, it is really challenging to get the number of different ideas under one roof because a set of brilliant minds working in every country and each of them have their own ideas, and getting all of them together under one roof, getting all their ideas together in one roof and agreeing on one set is a challenge. So we're taking it one step and after another. The first step is to just get them together and at least share their ideas to see what can be done. And of course, the lack of adequate volunteers. We really don't have the amount of volunteers that we would really love to have in the working group to be able to consolidate and share and document these ideas. We found one answer to the challenge. That's you. Because you are taxonomy owners, you're regulators, you own taxonomies, you're taxonomy architects, you're taxonomy consumers in terms of software, you're taxonomy consumers in terms of companies, you're taxonomy consumers in terms of wellness. So you are the best people to help us in this initiative and share your experience of taxonomy in each of your jurisdictions. And I would definitely urge, it won't take much of your time in sharing these ideas and getting us all together to meet these short-term objectives. That's it from my side. Thank you.